So guys, what is up? Just a little bit of an intro to this video. First off, I'm very sorry that this might be the only video I put up today. My voice has been absolutely awful. It's been going in and out all day. So I did have to choose to upload something where I'm not talking a whole bunch. So this is pre-recorded from the stream I did a couple days ago. It was my first hands-on, and I think most people's public first hands-on, with the ARK Survival of the Fittest Free Standalone, which is now available on Steam. You can get it. You do not need ARK. That's the thing a lot of people are asking about. You don't need ARK. It's absolutely free. Go ahead, try it out. It's only Survival of the Fittest. You still have to buy ARK to play, like, in a constant world, building, surviving, that type of stuff. But if you want to play a Survival of the Fittest game mode, it's free, and anyone can buy it. So this is my first attempt, very feeble attempt. It was my YOLO attempt. Go towards the middle. And I died. Spoiler alert, but you'd find that out within about 30 seconds, so no worries. But I did something interesting that I kind of want to get your guys' opinion on, and that is I ended up shoutcasting the other half, so let me know how I did in the comments, and if this is the type of video you might want to see in the future, whether that be for Survival of the Fittest, for, like, I don't know, just anything, shoutcasting over anything, which is just commentating over, like, competitive play, like CSGO, which wouldn't be too good because I don't know a lot about that, but maybe, Halo, any of that stuff. So just let me know what you think about this. If I did a good job, I'd seriously appreciate it. And hopefully my voice is better tomorrow and I can record some new stuff. If not, though, and this isn't the shoutcasting isn't your type of tea or your cup of tea, no worries. I got a second Survival of the Fittest video coming out tomorrow, which is the one where I actually did a little bit better because I had a little bit more strategy. Air quotes around strategy, though. So let me know how I did and hope you guys do enjoy the video. A little bit something different, but I thought you guys might like it. And like I said, hopefully my voice gets better. If you can go back to having some fun recording times. Other than that, though, thank you guys so much for listening to me yabble on and enjoy the shoutcast and quick death too if you're into that.
Panic!
Oh, no, Kelly.
What's going on? What's going on? I don't know. Okay. This is it. This is it. Ah! Let's go. Where are we going? I don't know. Okay. We're going down. Everyone's going down. Oh God. Oh no. I don't know where to go. Oh wait, it's a 45 minute match? I thought it was 35 minute matches. Well, I was lied to. Okay, well, good luck, have fun. Hopefully this works out well for us. If not, I don't know. I'm going in and grab some stuff though. YOLO. I need stuff. Oh my God, my graphics for this are way worse than I remember them. I did not put the graphics to the right settings. Oh no. Okay, you know what? Just grabbing some crap, whatever. I don't know what I'm grabbing, but I'm running out of here after I grab it. There we go. We got stuff. Don't know what we got. We're out of here, boys! We are out of here. Oh. Dodge and weave. I hope no one's following us. Okay, we're about to run out of stamina, too. That's not good. Don't punch me. Oh, no. She's got something. Ah! There we go. Jump off the edge. Nope. I'm out. Ah! Gotta dip. This might not work out well for me. No, have peace with me, please! Oh shit, she's got a spear. I'm ripped. I should not have ran towards the middle. Well, that was quick. Well, I don't know. We got this. This one isn't too interesting. Let's go ahead. Keep looking around. Keep guessing around. I can't see who we're spectating, though, which is unfortunately the problem. There is no name pop-up with who we are spectating, so we just know that it's someone. But here we have the shirted man, as we will refer to him. He has a shirt and a hatchet, and he's looking around. Oh, he's very close to T-Rex. This could be something. There's a monkey attacking a dillo, and this guy's ballsy. He's shooting a T-Rex with stones. I think he has a death wish. There is no way in hell he's going to be able to knock this thing out unless Topor levels are a lot lower for this game mode. He's seeming... I bet I shower naked. Okay. Supply overload. Yeah, so as you can see, events are coming in quite... hello. Ants are coming. I'm going to do some damage to this guy. I can't see any stats on him, though, so I don't know what's up with him there. That T-Rex is still kind of near. It's a little bit further away. He's not in too much danger. You can see a red airdrop in the distance. Oh, a cold monkey is seemingly attacking him. This could be lethal. So, I mean, those cold monkeys, those poop they fling. I was about to say they drop sanity. That's don't starve. But they're doing something. I do not have delay on, I do not believe. And here we are going. Doing stuff. T-Rex is still in the distance. He's kind of trending towards him. He might be in a bad situation. He's coming towards him. He's ripped.
He's ripped. He's gonna die. That T-Rex is on him. I don't know how he's still surviving. He's slow. He's injured. That the T-Rex got distracted by Adilla. Oh, he's coming though. He's circling. I don't know what he's doing. This man is the luckiest man alive. Literally, he just dodged a T-Rex to death. From how slow he was moving, I could guess he was below 25%. Unfortunately, he's encountering some more of these cold monkeys, which that poop can be pretty deadly, and it's gonna be doing some damage here. Those Arctic monkeys are not to be messed with, but they're not in a horde, so it shouldn't be too big of a deal. He's able to actually kill it. Oh, the body's gone. That thing went straight to bumfuck. And oh no! Well, they might not be in a horde. They seem to be in pairs. They're doing some damage. And he's getting hurt himself. He's walking real slow. I'm guessing he's back down under 25%. Black Text, that's just my name. I'm guessing he's back under 25% health, so he's really struggling to just kind of make it by. Luckily for him, that T-Rex is distracted. He's on the other side of the river. And there isn't anything too lethal really by him. If anything, he could go for that red airdrop over there to try. Oh no, there is. Oh, he actually doesn't see this yet. If you look at where this head's pointing, he might not be prepared for this T-Rex attack. And if he isn't, it's literally on. Oh no, I think he might see it here. The question is, will the T-Rex aggro him? If it does, no, it aggroed a Fiomio, which is lucky for him because his health is still pretty low. There's no way he was able to regenerate after being down like 25-ish percent. But that, oh, he's getting hit by a Mega Nuera, and those things are going to keep him occupied for a while. There's a Dillo behind him, and this T-Rex is coming in. I don't know what this T-Rex is doing. Oh, well, Slip died, I think. So we were spectating Slip. Well, Slip's dead. So unfortunately, Slip wasn't able to make it. So let's go ahead and go on to the next guy, see what's going on. It seems that we got a battle here. Oh, he is absolutely attempting to murder this T-Rex using a variety of Trank arrows. And the T-Rex is pretty preoccupied with the turtle that it's really not able to kill. I'm kind of worried he might not be able to knock out the T-Rex. With how bloody that thing is, he might kill it before it's even tameable. That's the case. He's running away. He's trying to craft up some more arrows. Problem is that T-Rex is in a battle with the turtle. Has he killed the turtle yet? No, I still see it moving, so he's still a bit preoccupied. So that's good for him. He's hiding in the grass. Is he another player? I don't know, but someone else died. Mad Morph, the German guy. That might have been who killed us. I saw German up top. And he's going back. Oh, he was crouching so we could craft some stuff. He's going back to tame the T-Rex. We could be seeing something insane, especially with this drop that comes in double taming. If he's able to knock him out, he's gonna have a T-Rex in his repertoire insanely quickly. The question is, will he be able to kill it before, will he be able to tame it? That's a big blow. He wasn't able to knock it out. He killed it. Good news is, that's a hefty chunk of XP going his way for murdering a T-Rex. I don't know what the XP levels are. I don't know what he's unlocked. I can't see anything about this guy's inventory. But with 17 contestants left, and I'm guessing a hefty chunk of XP should be in pretty good shape. Let's go to the next guy. He seems to have claimed a Dillo with the flag, and he's capitalizing on the double taming. It looks like he's going to try to get a trike and a stego. I want to see how long this takes. I'm not entirely sure. This could be good info for our next match, and this is actually good stuff for us to spectate. And I think he might have put some berries on the trike. He probably just put berries. There's no way he has anything else. Question is, how long is it going to take him to tame these two? But with double taming, this is insane, and with the frequency of these events that are going on, this is kind of ridiculous. I'd guess 3, maybe 4 minutes, we have an event going on. We just had Arctic monkeys, we had extra supply drops, we had all that stuff. So this is Zul'jin we're watching. Okay, so apparently we're watching Zul'jin. He's going for a herbivore taming strategy. He's gonna have 3 dinosaurs to his name if he's able to capitalize. And it looks like he's going down the river. I don't know what he's going for. He might be trying to kill this parasaur. Yes, he is. He's using his Dillo to kill it, along with, in combination with his bow. And that Dillo's doing a pretty good job of just kind of keeping him slowed down. I think the Dillo was able to spit on him, which is actually a pretty nice tactic. And he should be able to get some meat there. I don't know on the status of his guys up there. I think they're still in the process of being tamed. I see they're raised a talon. Thanks for stopping by. And he's just going to get as much meat as possible from this guy. We've got 30 minutes left in the match. Almost half of the contestants are dead already, which is crazy. Because in normal games, in normal Survival of the Fittest games that you're used to playing, half of the people aren't dead until a while into the game. The thing is, this mode is a lot shorter and it's a lot more bite-sized, so it's a lot easier for players to play in. And it also has rewards for winning. I don't know if the rewards are actually in the game yet, as I checked the replace hoarders, but there are rewards. Mad Morph is killing. Oh no, they're dying in German. I don't know why they're dying in German. I guess that's a thing. So yeah, and we're down to 15. Wow. So half the contestants dead already. This is, at least for normal survival of the fittest standards, unprecedented, because half of the people usually are not dead until, I don't know. I don't play a lot of survival of the fittest. I'm going off a rough memory, I'd say maybe halfway-ish through the match. But like I was saying, this is a lot more bite-sized of a format. We got free-for-all going on, so no teammates, no tribe mates. And the thing is that they are, I thought they were going to be 35 minutes, turns out they're 45. So very bite-sized and a lot more playable, so you don't have to set aside 2-4 hours for whichever one you want to play. You can literally just pop in like, I got an hour to spare and fit one, maybe two games in, depending on how quickly it goes. It appears that an herbivore drop is currently going on, so some herbivores should be spawning near our friend here. And he got a plethora of ankylosaurs. They are on the friendly side, and a little bit dangerous to tame because there are four of them, so he probably doesn't want to go for that. But he should be able to continue that taming. By the looks of it, this process isn't the longest. We'll stick around here with what I assume to be Z up until these guys are tamed. The double taming event is up, by the way, so that's no longer being applied. They're under normal speed now, but for that kind of first chunk of their bar, they were under double taming. I can't see how much they're at. Maybe someone in chat knows how much based off of Z's stream. But going off of this, and we have another kill this time. I can't read German, so one of those killed the other guy. That's what I got. I don't know why my game's in German. I've never done anything German in my life. Like, I'm Polish. I'm like neighbors to Germany. I don't know if that counts. But in terms of other stuff, our good friend Royal is actually still alive. We might go ahead and give him a peek. But, like I said, I want to just keep on looking with this guy, because with how short the matches are, at 45 minutes, these taming timers, they have to be shorter, but he's already past a third of the way. It's Dutch? Okay, it's Dutch. He's already a third of the way past, or he's completed a third of the game, time-wise, and nothing, like, I don't know, man. I don't know, the tames are still a ways out, so I don't know if taming is really, I don't know if taming is a viable method in this, because, I mean, maybe if he's saving up for endgame, they might be viable, because he'll end up having three dinosaurs in the final showdown. The question is anyone else taming up any dinosaurs? So let's kind of scroll through, see what's up. We got this very short, I think this is the pygmy woman? No, the pygmy woman died, I think. I don't know. We got this very short lady chilling in the forest, chopping down some wood. Nothing too. It was German? Okay. Oh, we got whoever this guy is. He's got a carno down. Ooh. Now this could be something. The question is, again, in terms of taming, I don't know how much it is. I don't know who this is. Did you die? I died within about the first 30 seconds, but hey, it's a record for the new survival of the fittest for me, so I'm happy. I was the second guy to die. I get that. I get to claim that. Don't know who I'm watching. Maybe one of you guys do. I don't know why spectate mode doesn't actually show anything, but if some of you guys might know who it is. Oh no, he made a big mistake. If you guys notice in the background, the dome is closing around him. He's not get. Oh. Oh no. What a waste of a tame. This is crazy. He spent all that time. I don't know how long he spent taming up that carno. He's weighing his options. He sees this thing coming in, and I think he's going to be giving up on this carno. He knows he can't do anything about it. And unless that barrier takes the carno with it, he's not going to be able to finish his tame. He's panicking. He's walking around. I don't know what he's doing. Apparently Royal's going for the Pteranodon tame. We'll go ahead and pop in on him a little bit. He'll be the one taming a Pteranodon. And I think you can see just based off of this guy's actions that he's given up. He's sticking around. He wants to wait till the last second. Unfortunately, odds are not looking good with him. That barrier is going to be at him within, at the rate it's moving, a minute to 2 minutes. That Carnal's going to be completely out of play. So yeah. That's how I died from the dome. Yeah, I died. I died from, or no, I didn't die from the dome. I died from someone killing me. I didn't even have enough time to run to the dome. But we got this guy dying over here and doing things. Stuff and things, as the famous Slip would say. And he's not going to be able to get it. He's donezo. I think he's accepted that fact, and Thank you so much. I gotta see who donated this. Also, Drax just died. To Pedro Saltana's Pteranodon, I believe is what that is. So hold up very quickly. Thank you, Maddie May 13, for the $10 donation. So hold up. Let me actually resize this a little bit so I can actually see it. Thank you, Maddie May, for the $10 donation. I don't know why my pop-ups have been weird lately. I really got to get on that. So, hey, sorry, I just want to say hello and wanted to see how you are. Hope you like the gift. $10, and I hope the music didn't scare you. It scared me a little bit. I wasn't expecting a donation. But thank you so much, Maddie May, for the sub. Boys and girls, can get some heart spam in chat, especially if you're a sub. Use them special hearts and show off our gratitude as our arena continues to close and our combatants continue to draw themselves closer. Whoever this is, I don't know who it is yet. I wish I did. I wish there were names. They're probably gonna patch that in. But he's swimming. He's on the outside edge of the map. Nothing too exciting going on here. Here we got someone crouching. And he seems to be lurking. It seems... Oh, this is a... Depending on how he plays this, he might have himself a T-Rex or Spino tame. The problem is, if he knocks out one of these guys, there's a Spino dangerously close to him. So he's gonna have to be able to either kill one or knock out both of them, and we got Mazion dying too. We're down to 12 contestants with just over, we're about halfway through the game. This guy's getting chased by the T-Rex. His odds aren't looking good. That T-Rex, it's getting distracted though. And another T-Rex down by the shore, followed by a Spino. The good news is he was able, whoever this is, to lure him away from the beach. The beach is a little bit more of a lethal area due to kind of that high volume and density of Spinosaurs and T-Rexes. He's actually been able to get the T-Rex to aggro onto other beasts, which should give whoever this is a chance to do some nice damage to that T-Rex. Well, not damage, but to pour. Problem is, you can see that dome closing in, and I mean, that's the time, that's the clock that's ticking, the one that's keeping everyone on their toes. If, oh, crouching now, trying to be stealthy, and oh, hold up, I don't know if you guys saw that in the distance, we actually saw a rock break. I don't know if that was player made or potentially a creature doing that, but there was a broken rock in the distance. This person might be close. If he tries to tame the T-Rex, it'll be in danger because it's going to be awfully close to another player. And if this one's preoccupied with the T-Rex tame, that other guy could kill this person, or at the very least, kill the tame. We got a supply overload coming in. Means there should be some drops. Whoever this is, not much going on in terms of drops. They seem to be ditching the T-Rex idea. And just kind of be, looks like they're drawing closer to the middle of the map. And in terms of size, I'm thinking this map's definitely a lot smaller than survival or other game modes. Royal's tame failed. Damn. Well, I don't know. We might go ahead and switch over to Royal a bit. This one just kind of had an inland, not much going on. And oh, Darkrell TV. There you go. There you have it. That's why those T-Rexes down by the shore, they're lethal. You can't just go around taming that. I mean, you gotta be cautious. This might be Royal. This seems like a place you might find a Pteranodon. Nothing too lethal in terms of the beach. She's, whoever this is, pretty close, pretty in the clear in terms of everything. And just collecting some rocks with his hatchet. So he's using rocks. I don't know what this is gonna be used for. I don't know what he could be saving up for with this plethora of rocks, unless he's trying to get a lot of slingshot ammo. But I don't know, he's actually building a house and for protection, I guess that's solid. What's up, Venom 7388? What's up? Haven't seen you in a while, man. Welcome. He's built himself a little 2x1 wooden hut with a ramp, a couple doors. Nothing too insane here. More people starting to play Survival of the Fittest now. Pedro is a level 24 at this point. With all these murders he's getting, he has to be getting a higher level, and some of the stuff that's going to be available to him, that's going to be pretty high. Damn. Well. Also, nothing to keep an eye on. This cabin's not going to be relevant for too much longer. It should be. I'd have to guess with the rate that this is going. 5 more minutes. Anywhere from 5 to 10 minutes isn't going to be useful. So he's got it for another fourth to half of the game. And it's good. It's a safe place. And he's able to... I don't know what he's doing in there. I wish I could check. He seems to be smelting something up. I'm guessing that's going to be metal. And he's making some tools. So he might be quite well prepared for any encounters going on. I'm guessing most of the other combatants do not have on them metal tools, so that's going to be a huge advantage depending on how much metal he can get. That's the big question. And whoever's here, really close to an airdrop, landing on top of an airdrop, nothing I've ever seen before, but by the looks of it, the dome might be closed in past that supply drop, so it might not even matter. It appears that the dome's actually disappeared now. I don't know, I see it. It's kind of a little bit weird to see over in that direction. But I think it's enclosed around the supply drop. So not much you're going to be getting here. This is Royal that we're watching, or is Royal this guy? This guy. Is this guy Royal? I don't know who's Royal. Which one is it? Zujin apparently successfully tamed his trike. Jen committed suicide. A level 120 parasaur. Royal's at the barrier. What barrier? Oh, the dome? Okay, that would make sense. Whoever this is seems to be killing a parasaur. Trying to get themselves a little bit of food. Nothing too crazy if we look around a little bit more. You can see someone crawling, lurking. Nothing too aggressive. We're down to 9 people. Damn is all I can say. Huh. Well, hold up. I'm trying to read something real quick. Yeah, I was just looking at a quick patch that's going to be coming out. But with 18 minutes to go, we're down to 9 people. Another carnivore drop, which is definitely going to be a lot more frightening. And we're probably going to see someone die. This guy has a T-Rex dropped right on him, but he ran past an ankle sore. He's going to be safe from the deadly carnos. This guy has a couple of T-Rexes lurking by him. And another player. Oh, this is going to be something to watch. This is something. You got a multitask. You got a T-Rex trying to kill you. And even if you win this, you gotta be careful. Whoever this is, by the way, they're gonna die. I don't know if these are Topor arrows. The T-Rex, it's buggered off, by the way. It's gone. That's not even gonna be a problem. These guys, battling out, doing whatever the hell it is that two battling people do. And he's crouching. He's drop shot. This is Modern Warfare 2. He's bringing it back. Throwback Thursday, except it's a Tuesday. But this guy doesn't care. He's running. And someone died. But I think as one of them died, the other one was knocked unconscious. He is so lucky that that T-Rex ran away. If it wasn't for that T-Rex running away, he'd be, well, like T-Rex food right now. He'd be pretty dead. But he survived with nothing but some really high topor and being knocked out for a while. Oh wait, no, he's dead. He's dead. The other guy was like blending in. God damn. Well, who's this guy? He's not dead. I thought he was knocked out. No, he's bona fidedly dead. Zujin died. Damn. So Zujin's dead. I guess that's Zujin we were watching. And this guy's roaming around. Chilling by a tree, nothing too exciting going on there. If we look at here, someone's harvesting up a ankylosaur. Or no, that's a turtle. Ankylosaur's in the background. Are those ankylosaurs, are those tamed? They seem to be hitting, I don't know if they're hitting, they're hitting the unconscious T-Rex, so he was actually able to knock a T-Rex out. Oh my god! This sucks donkey dick! He was able to knock a T-Rex out. And you know what? He's not going to be able to actually. No. Well, oh, that Anklo, he's mad. He's getting chased away from his own tame. But I think he was able to draw their aggro away from the T-Rex, so that shouldn't be a problem. And with 7 players left, Bonge, I am the walrus. This is the same guy we were watching before. We got another T-Rex by there going to battle with all these ankylosaurs. And we're down to 7. This is going quick. This is not lasting long. This is, if this was the normal game type, we'd still have 3.5 hours to go. Was the first game 4 hours or 6 hours? I forget. Over here, you know, just chilling by a tree. I don't know if they're scared of someone. Someone's coming for them. But they're pretty well camouflaged. Their pickaxe does reveal them a little bit. But if you're not looking, it's pretty camouflaged. And at a glance, you're not going to be able to notice that. Go on next. We can see here someone is starting up a fire, looking around for resources, and he seems to be on the hunt. He's not crouching, he's laying down. And well, he's waiting, he's lying in wait. I don't know what for. He might just be trying to disassociate himself from that fire. So someone does come by and investigate it. So hold up, this might be a trap that he's doing. And apparently this is Royal. He might be trying to rule someone. A little bit congested. He's trying to lure someone into that fire to kind of investigate. Well, it looks like it didn't work. That or he was just kind of staying away from it. Either or, still a pretty smart move. And Royal, I mean, he's got a bow, and I believe that a Bronto has dropped by him. He's back to laying down. I don't know why exactly, but he's doing it. He's 1 of 7. He set a trap. Okay. Now another guy here lurking. The giant Bronto by him, up by a rock. He's actually back by the middle. His legs are split in an extremely weird way, and they're actually merging through the ground. He is one with the survival of the fittest. He's getting food. Okay, that makes sense. He's sliding down, and oh, he slid down into the nest of the T-Rex. This might be the end for him. No. The T-Rex seems to be preoccupied with other things. He doesn't seem too interested with this guy. That T-Rex wants the Bronto. And that, oh my god, there's countless people getting lucky with aggros right now. They're just situations upon situations where someone should have died and they haven't, simply because of lucky aggros. That T-Rex, I don't know where it is. You know what I think this guy's doing? He may have actually aggroed it. He might have just juked it out from weird stuff. And he might be trying to tame it. I don't know. Are those Trank arrows he has equipped? Yeah, they got the green tint to him. He has Trank arrows on him. And he's looking around for that T-Rex, but that T-Rex has kind of avoided him around the brim of the arena, so he's not going to be too big of a problem here. But if we keep on looking around, see what else everyone else is up to, we can see that... Well, I don't know yet. Frankly, I don't know where this guy is. I think he's by the brim of the arena, so we got two contestants over by the arena, chilling, and... I don't know, frankly, where they are. I don't know if they're next to the same ramp, if they're on different ramps. But I guess we'll find out in a bit here. So, yeah, he can't. He died. Who died? Did Royal die? I don't think so. Whoever this is, hitting up some rocks. I think this is another guy going for a base build and armor up strategy. In terms of the barrier is not in worrying distance, I don't think. We can actually look around here really quick and see where the barrier is. And by the looks of it, barrier's right here. He's still got... good amount of time, because I mean, he was like right around this area. Arena's right up there. Nice secluded area. He should be pretty good to go. So he's doing all right there. Let's continue, however. Looking around on our players. Let's, well, who is here? It was here for a second. The camera is, however, detached. I don't know. Okay, there we go. Now it's attached. We got someone in some even thicker bush, which is going to be even harder to see. And they're playing the waiting game. They're chilling by the edge of the dome. That's kind of their strategy, whoever this is. They're trying to be last one alive. This is Royal, you're telling me? Yeah? Well, he's just going for kind of a survive everything type of deal. Yeah, I don't know what's going on. Nothing too lethal by him. He seems to be pretty safe, so he's not in too much danger. He's by the edge. If I had to make a prediction, unless he gets squashed by this dome due to that rock, but I think he's smarter than that. Should be able to get away. How did I die? I YOLO'd too hard. That's how. But we continue looking around. Still 7 contestants left. This guy is also going with that strategy. But check this out. He has chitin armor. So he's going to be the most... out of everyone I've seen, he's the most well-equipped. Oh, this is... this could be bad for all the people without shelter. I don't know what he's doing. He's right by the edge of the border. He's getting acid rained on. And... he's got to try and build a thatch roof ASAP, but if he can, this might murder him. So it might be a good idea for future contestants next game. I probably want to have a thatch foundation, a wall, and a roof ready to go just so we can hide under this acid rain. This is going to be going on for a couple minutes. This guy's playing a race against time. Unfortunately, I don't think it's going to work out for him. Also, that was some very trippy black and white. But ever so slowly, I think this acid rain... we'll murder him, and that's just bad. That's bad news bears right there, and unfortunately for him, he's not a bear, so it's just bad news. He's collecting the fiber, collecting the thatch. He might still be able to pull off the crafts, but the problem is, with chilling right there and the fact he's probably crafting, he might get pushed into that rock by the dome, and that might just trap him. He's outside of the arena. Is there, I don't know what happens. You just lose health when you're outside of the arena. I'm not going to check. I like lifting, but yeah, what up, Radoslavos99, how you doing? And our contestants, ever so slowly, they're being lured closer and closer to the arena. What? There's a Bronto up there. I don't know if it's swinging at something. I think the Bronto and the T-Rex are up in a fight there. I will check this out, see if anyone is over by there. That guy, pretty big risk of acid rain death. Whoever's going on here, we got a T-Rex hunting a Bronto. So that's going interesting. Anyone in the middle, by the way, maybe by the brim? At a quick glance, I'm not seeing anyone, so let's go ahead, scroll through, see what is up. And, oh, someone was able, I don't know if they had it ready, but they were able to get that thatch, whatever the hell you want to call it. It's a roof. Well, I was going to call it a hut, but that's not much of a hut if it doesn't have 3 other walls. So he's got that going for him. Acid rain stopped, so no one died from it. Lucky them. That could have been a close call. And then here we got a guy with an arrow running away from what seems to be nothing. There we go. This guy running around right now, just a running game. Ain't nothing lethal going on. This guy still has his base. And I don't know. He's the guy with chitin too. Ooh. This could do some work. He's trying to get as much out of there as possible before That dome encloses around him, so he's running out of time. He's going to be cutting it a little bit close. But in the end, I think he should still be relatively fine. I don't think it'll be a big issue for him. He has a stone pick. He's hitting that rock. He's trying to get some last second metal, but it doesn't... maybe just trying to get flint. I don't know. If he's trying to get metal from that, not going to matter because, well, that's going on. So, yeah, he's... I think he was. He might just be grabbing the remnants. That barrier's closing in really close on him. He might be out of time. If he gets caught, no, he sees it coming. He's going last second. He's going to get pushed up against that barrier. If he can't make it out of that door, he might get squashed. No, he's not being pushed out. I don't know. What happens if you're outside? Ralph is a level 28, you're telling me. Oh, a Carno drop. This could kill a couple more of our contestants. He's running back into there. He cares not. Oh, this is bad. There are raptors waiting outside his base. They're going to be keeping him out of bounds. This is awful news. Whoever this is just made a grave mistake right as the carnivore drop's going on. He is trapped. He had to destroy a wall. He's running. He's trying to catch the barrier, and he somehow does. Jesus, I don't know how this guy's still alive. I don't know how he juked out those raptors. There's a T-Rex right by him. Jesus, he's cutting it close, but with surviving that, he has the best gear out there from a quick glance, and he's... gonna be able to do some murdering. This guy, he's chilling. Don't know what he's doing. This guy, also chilling. It looks like there's a raptor. He tried to get him to aggro a trike. Looks like he succeeded. The Carno drop killed no one. It actually got this guy. He's checking their inventory. He's trying to find something real quick. He's not finding nothing. At least I don't think he is. This guy was able to kill a raptor. I don't know where the other two are. And that Carno drop was not as disastrous as I thought it'd be. Oh, but here we got a battle. We got one going on, down to seven players. We're going to have six after the end of this, unless there's some retreats going on. But that's not happening. He gets the headshot and takes his ass out. Hot damn. I wish I could get a slow motion replay of that with like some, I don't know, I need some epic dubstep music. That was a freaking headshot. He wasn't even going with topor arrows either. He was going for the kill, and he got it, and... he's going to be getting some loot off him. Unfortunately, if that's not the guy with chitin, I don't know what loot there is that's going to be useful, unless maybe arrows, a bow if he doesn't have one, but everyone here has such crappy loot. It doesn't matter. This chitin guy, if he's the last one in a brawl, unless maybe he's up against Ralph, who is a really high level and who has murdered quite a few contestants, he's going to, you know, he's going to do some work. I don't, this guy's munching on food. He's waiting by the barrier. He murdered someone. We just missed a murder here. Partially, Royal was killed by Kappa Pride, I think. So Royal dying last second, but he was able to get top six placement. And this is the point where action starts happening as the arena gets exponentially smaller. I think it's exponential, right? Because it's a circle. Yeah, because the radius is increasing at a constant rate. So it's exponentially smaller or quadratically. I don't know. We got a dead raptor rolling down. We got a couple dead raptors. And we got another encounter going on. I don't know if the first guy sees him. This is going to be a bow battle coming in. Other guys jumping around. Oh my god, they're both volleying shots each other's way. There's a raptor coming in. This is going to be the wild card. And he's getting chased by him. He's got two problems to focus with. He's using a parachute, which is kind of ingenious the way he used that. And he was able to knock out that raptor. Problem is, he's kind of close to the other raptor too, if you can see there. And he's getting chased by that too. This guy is running into the wrong alley. He's just going down. There, he's killing him. But the problem is, they're chipping his health down, and they're not, he's drop shot, he's doing everything, they're chipping his health down, and Pedro gets another murder. Down to the final four, Pedro has the most kills to his name. His level is probably 30 at this point, because he killed him at level 28. Pedro's a cold-blooded murderer. He murdered me in calling, that's all I remember. Oh, is he ready for the acid rain, though? The thing is, looking off his character, he's not too damaged. He should have time to get under some cover, create some cover. I think he'll be fine. Nothing too worrying there. But we got to keep an eye out for Pedro because he is by and far away the favorite. Someone's got a crossbow, but they're naked. So that's not, I don't know. I don't have too much faith in that guy. He doesn't even have any armor. Got someone here with a bow, but the wild card. Actually, no. Where is Mr. Chitin? He's not here. He might actually be one of the naked people taking off his armor. So it would actually make sense that it is the guy with the crossbow. He's waiting for the acid rain to wear out. He's trying to survive this. And if he does, he'll be able to go into there with, well, what is it? I'm having a brain fart. His chitin armor. He's got a crossbow too. He's going to be able to You might have a spear even. I don't know. Looking around, no encounters yet. People are playing the waiting game. Someone's actually built a pillar to use as cover. It's someone with a crossbow. And oh, here we have Mr. Kitan himself. Don't know who that is. But this is the guy with the house. This is the man who had some real estate to his name before the barrier took it away from him. And well, he's ready. He's ready. Cloud Legend, no. I don't hate you. Why? Why would I do that? This is a waiting game, and they're just going to slowly be closed into the center. Do we still have someone waiting on the outside? No, he's slowly crawling his way in. Don't know who that is. He's a naked man. We got someone here in a hut. And in terms of the pillar, I believe this is on the other side of the arena. I don't know where that pillar is. Oh, there it is. So he probably doesn't even see him. The pillar probably doesn't see him. Mr. Pillar's running away. This guy is cutting it quite close. Who is this? Does he not realize he's going to be losing some health running through that? He's really going for that turtle strategy last second, and it might bite him in the ass because he has quite the route to run if he wants to get up there. I don't know if he's going to make it. He's at full health. Don't know how much health he loses from the barrier, but he might be going down from this, and if he does, well, that's going to be an awful way to go down because there are no other encounters. He's waiting it out. He's waiting until the very last second. I don't know if he's going to stay out of bounds, try and heal it up. I don't know what he's doing. He's chilling. He's waiting that barrier. They're face to face. And it looks like his strategy is run. Thank God. I did not want him to go out like that. The problem is he's got a ramp. He's got a little route over here. He's got to run. He's looking like a wide receiver from the NFL. No worries. That zag play is going to pay off if he can survive. Because that's the thing about NFL receivers. They're not slowly dying because they're outside of some magical dome. They're just catching balls. Here's the thing. He's coming in from side where he can see that wooden structure. I don't know if someone's still on that wooden structure. We got Mr. Kitan over here in terms of the wooden structure also there. So we got three guys on the wooden structure. And whoever is here just turtling. Not turtling. He's playing. He's hiding. He's just going for it. But if we look over here, we can see an encounter about to take place. We got two guys both seemingly closing in on the wooden structure. Well, no. No. Actually, I don't know what happened. Someone came out of the wooden structure. Got one guy lurking all the way back there. And we got another guy there. Third guy, he's just playing the crawl game over there at the border. So I don't know what's going on with him. He's just going for the turtle strategy. I don't know. We got the players list. Someone's saying hit N for players list. That isn't working. You lied to me. How could you? And I don't know if this person can see the other players. Oh, he definitely sees one. We got an herbivore drop coming in. That could have been a lot deadlier with a carnivore, but it's okay. Just an herbivore. Shouldn't be too lethal. Herbivores usually are not of the violent variety, but they do add another target. Oh, control N. There we go. So here's who we got. We got Mr. Dolphin, Pedro Saltana, Trooms, and Decky. The four remaining survivors. The thing is, Ralph is by and far away the favorites. Now, I seem to have lost my encounter. We got someone chilling over by his little hut. Don't know what he's doing. We got some rocks that I thought was a dead body for a sec. And in terms of encounters, nothing going on right now. Everyone seems to kind of just be chilling. I don't know if Mr. Crawley Crawls is still all the way over there. Is that him? Oh, we actually just missed a murder. How could I? I've dishonored my people. Well, someone's died. Someone's in the hut. So how did that guy die? I don't know. There's probably another battle. He probably just killed him. Mr. Kitan with the... Oh, hold up. We have two people with Kitan and crossbows. And one of those is likely going to be Pedro Saltana. Right now he's running around the ring. He's playing a little bit of an aggressive game. The thing is, if he doesn't notice Mr. Stalker, which is actually right behind him, he might be in for some trouble, but he noticed him, and here we are going to have the battle that will probably decide the winner, and whoever's third, they got to come in and do something, because whoever wins this, they're going to be heavily out-armoring whoever isn't. So right here, this is, in my opinion, a race for first place, this little battle right here, and whoever's using that crossbow is hitting this guy a little bit with the arrows. He's got a couple hits in. He's switched to his bow. Oh, it's officially a three-way, boys and girls. We got three people. Don't know what they're doing. Well, they're fighting each other. That's what they're doing. And one standing still. He's closest to this guy. That person in leather armor, I don't know if they can do it. This guy's drop shot. He's really slow. And Shrooms dies to Pedro. Pedro is the one. Pedro is the underdog. He has no chitin. He just has raw skill. And I think he might be pulling this off. He's outstrafing them. He's outmaneuvering them. He's doing everything in his power to win. And the better stats on this guy's armor and weapons, they might not do the trick. Down to two tribes. Down to the wire. I don't know who's going to win. I wish I could see health. based off of bloodiness. Whoever's in the chitin is winning because I see no blood, but he's got about one arrow in him. Pedro's got a couple more. I don't think Pedro's healed since the last battle. Pedro might be at a disadvantage. Problem is, he's got more health. He's a higher level. Whoever's left, well, we got Pedro the 32 and Mr. Dolphin the 21. He is that many levels higher. Mr. Dolphin, the man in the chitin. Looking around, he's out strafing. He has to take advantage of this. He has the advantage. Pedro is so hurt compared to him, but he doesn't know what stats he put his stats into. He's going to the melee. He's chasing Pedro. Pedro, by and far away. He has to have taken more damage. Oh, but he's losing his chitin armor. He's reloading his crossbow. He's getting stabbed. And Pedro comes out with the win. Jesus Christ. That was legendary. Out. He was... I don't know, man. He wasn't outnumbered. But if you look at what he was able to accomplish... Oh my god, my rank. I don't know, where's my rank? I was still 1.5. Whoever Pedro, where's Pedro? I need to see Pedro, because Pedro... did... some lethal things there. Oh. My. God. That, my friends, was insane. Down to the wire, and Pedro... he doesn't care that the other contestants, they got better loot than him. Guess what? Pedro gives that many shits. You know what Pedro does? He murders them. He picks them off one by one. He capitalizes on them fighting each other. And pretty much, he shits on their beds while they're sleeping. So, yeah. I don't know. Anyway, server's restarting. I will talk to you guys in a little bit.